Wow, a lot of people left me comments. Cool. What? I have a crappy video?
What is it? Random videos.
Oh. Hey you.
Me?
Are you having a hard time because people are leaving you bad comments on YouTube because you have a crappy video? If so, that's okay, because today I'm gonna show you how to make a video for the web. There are three necessary steps that any filmmaker must take in order to make a good-looking video, especially if you want it to be seen by millions of people on a website such as YouTube. The first step in this process is known as pre-production.
See that guy back there? He's just turning on the camera and running out the door. You're probably not gonna wanna do that. Hey, where you going?
I'm going to your mama's house.
How dare you?
Nothing's this tight, I'm shooting an awesome YouTube video because I'm a super awesome photographer, man.
Instead of running out the door with the camera, it is a good idea to first plan out your production by writing a script. It not only saves you time and money, but gives you a better video in the end. Once you have completed pre-production, you're now ready to move forward to the production phase.
See this guy? This is what you're not supposed to do.
Dude, look at the sun! Oh, that shot's gonna look so good on YouTube! Oh, yeah! My eyes! My vision has been stricken! I'll never photographer again!
You should avoid handheld shots, which are shaky and bad for viewing on the web. Instead of shooting handheld, you should mount your camera on a tripod, which allows for smooth camera movements. Once you have completed production, you're ready for the last step in the process, which is known as post-production editing. Now that you have finished shooting, you're ready to edit your shots together. The sky's the limit in post-production, but be careful, don't get carried away like the guy on the left. Just because there is a variety of effects, doesn't mean that you should use them. Applying too many effects can make your video look bad, and hard to see on the web. Instead, keep your video clean and make simple cuts. By doing this, you will make your video much easier to see while streaming over the internet. Now that you have completed the three necessary steps in making a video for the web, you'll be ready to upload your video to a website such as YouTube. Whether your goal is great comments or a million views from people around the world, you can rest assured that you know what you're doing. Thank you for taking the time to watch How to Make a Video for the Web.
Wow, I think I'm really ready to make a good video now. Let's get out there, do it.
Well, that's the end of our video for today, guys. I hope you actually learned something.